Okay, so I'm going to tell you something about cell wall ultrastructure, and I think we're on cell wall ultrastructure 2, is that correct? Yes, good, okay. So we're going to look at how these different polymers interact with each other. We've just seen about how the microfibrils are laid down in the cell wall. So if I just draw schematically a microfibril made up of cellulose chains, on the surface of that microfibril we've got the hemicelluloses, which have this linear backbone but also these sort of coiled structures which act very much like springs. And then attached to the hemicelluloses, we've got the lignin, the cross-linked lignin structure, which I shall also show schematically. So we've got chemical bonds here between the lignin and the hemicelluloses, and between the hydroxyl groups of the hemicelluloses and the hydroxyl groups of the surface of the microfibril, we've got these hydrogen bonds. And then we also need to consider how the water interacts with this material. The water molecules come in and they basically are attracted to the hydroxyl groups in the polymers. These are schematic drawings of water molecules. And they enter the amorphous regions of the cell wall, which is primarily where the hemicelluloses and the lignin are located, especially where these hemicellulose amorphous regions are. But they do not enter the microfibrils. It's just not energetically favourable for them to go in there. So what they do is they expand the cell wall. So we've got these springs that are essentially being expanded by the presence of the water molecules. And they make the whole cell wall much more flexible, much more plastic in its behaviour. Okay.